Hello, welcome to Edify with me, Robert Mwando. Here we exalt, exhort, and edify. In our Edify Bite today, we talk about gladness in adversity. The unprecedented events of 2020 have tested humanity to the core. From the Hong Kong protests, the Australian bushfires, the Persian Gulf crisis, the global stock market crash, the COVID-19 pandemic, and its ravaging effects on world economies, the lockdown of states and places of worship, and now the ongoing protests following the killing of George Floyd by the police in the US. Who knew that a virus that can't move or fly on its own would shatter world economies? Who knew that the death of a little-known George Floyd would spark a movement that is set to change the world? Is there anyone who could have had foreknowledge of these events? My answer is affirmative. God did. It is true that we all go through trials, but these are what the Lord turns into triumphs. We go through tests that the Lord may translate them to testimonies. We are zeros so He can make us heroes. We are the nothings of this world so the Lord may make us something. We are often disgraced that the Lord may be gracious to us. We are lowly so the Lord may lift us up. Pressed on every side, but not crushed. Gone through the fire, but not consumed. Through the raging waters, but not swept off. Our troubles cannot stop the sound of the melody of our praise. The deeper our troubles, the louder our thanks to God who has led us through it all. Our cries are the tenor of our prayer. Our troubles are the bass chord of our life's song. To you who know that God knows, to you who believe that Christ lives, be filled with joy, for He shall restore the fortunes of Zion. And like the psalmist in chapter 126, we will return with songs of joy, declaring, "The Lord has done great things for us. Therefore, we are glad." This has been Edify with me, Robert Mwando. God bless you.